A good headphone setup can offer a great deal of benefits, such as privacy, better value compared to speakers, and best of all, not having to deal with room acoustics. Today, I will show you my favorite setup for under $2,000. Enjoy! Today's video is not a review, it's more of a showcase of my current headphone setup. The last 2 years I've been on a quest to find the perfect headphone setup. And after experimenting with a whole range of different DACs, cables, amps and headphones, I finally found a combination that I really like. The three main components in my setup are the RME 82 DAC FS, the Curious USB Evolved cable, and the Sennheiser HC660S headphones. Even though these products are from three unrelated manufacturers, they harmonize beautifully together. And perhaps that is because each of them is the end result of passion, dedication, and the evolution from well-established predecessors. RME is a German company that is primarily known for its pro audio products. And the 82 DAC FS is a typical example of German engineering. Serious and sensible, but also impressive and brilliant. The 82 DAC FS has evolved out of the very capable 82 Pro. And is RME's first consumer-oriented product. For a retail price of around $900, you get a half-rack size versatile black box that can be used as a DAC, a headphone amplifier, and a preamplifier with both balanced and unbalanced outputs. The 82 DAC FS uses the AKM AK4493 chip and can convert PCM data with a depth of 32 bits at sampling rates of up to 768 kHz, plus 1-bit data streams up to DSD256. In addition, there's the Static Lock FS, which ensures the lowest possible jitter values. At the back, there are balanced XLR and unbalanced RCA outputs that can be controlled with the rotary encoder at the front. The power supply is external, so you can easily upgrade that if you want. Nevertheless, the included power supply is of good quality, and the connector even has a locking mechanism to prevent it from accidentally slipping out. The only thing missing is an analog input, which I personally would have liked. At the front, there's a lot going on for such a compact device. First, there is the analyzer screen that displays the audio frequency spectrum and also guides you through the different menus. Then there are three high-precision rotary encoders with push functions. Turning the encoder mark B allows you to adjust the bass, and the encoder mark T does the same for the treble. Pressing either one lets you scroll through the different top screens. By default, pressing the volume rotary encoder mutes the current output. Turning it either left or right changes the volume. Pressing the volume menu button gives access to different volume options, as well as balance adjustment. The I/O menu reveals the settings for the three outputs, line out, phones, and IEM. Each output can be fully customized individually. The EQ button brings up a graphical equalizer display. Here you can adjust the equalizer and even name and store the preferred values for different headphones. The setup key gives access to the options and settings menus. The RME 82 DAC FS has an unbelievable amount of options and settings, enough to keep you entertained for a very long time. And as you can tell by the size of this manual, it would take ages to go through all of them. I'll put the link down here to the manufacturer's website so you can check out all the options and settings for yourself. The RME 82 DAC FS offers two TRS headphone outputs at the front. These are fed via two independent driver circuits, optimized for both high and low impedance headphones. The latter is said to have the world's lowest noise headphone output. Included with the RME is a nice size remote control with dedicated buttons for standby, volume, balance, bass and treble, input selection, mute, loudness and EQ. In addition, there are four programmable buttons that provide access to 52 different functions. With the RME 82 DAC FS, you get a DA converter for a really fair price that works just as well with a traditional hi-fi setup as well as with headphones. The 82 DAC FS is easy to use and looks the part. As for the sound quality, it is very accurate with an extraordinary amount of detail. Personally, this is something I love, but I can imagine that it even sounds a bit too technical for some. Still, thanks to the enormous amount of settings, you can tailor this DAC exactly to your taste. And that makes the RME 82 DAC FS the perfect playing partner for any kind of music. The next item in my setup that I want to show you guys is the Curious Evolved USB cable, all the way from Australia. In contrast to RME that puts a strong emphasis on measurements, Curious has claimed his fame through many satisfied customers and positive reviews. As the name Curious Evolved USB implies, this cable is an evolution of the original Curious USB cable that was first introduced in 2015. The original Curious USB cable already set a benchmark for affordable audiophile USB cables, but the Evolved raises the performance level even higher, with a beefed up ground system, decreased resistance and a lower noise floor. Just like the original Curious USB cable, the Evolved is handmade in Australia and designed by Rob Woodland, who is a passionate audiophile and manufacturer of affordable high-end cables. With the Curious USB cable, the power line is fully shielded and physically separated from the data lines. This prevents noise created by the computer power supply from affecting the pure silver, unshielded signal conductors. The 80 cm long Curious Evolved USB cable that I use in my setup retails for $550. And although this is by no means cheap, it is still far less than what you usually pay for a high-end USB cable. Now, many of you may ask, do you really need a high-end USB cable? Well, that depends. Any affordable, well-built USB cable will transfer a signal from your PC to your DAC, no doubt about that. But the only way to find out if upgrading a USB cable is a worthy investment to you is by listening with your own ears. Preferably at home with your own setup. I've tried a lot of USB cables in different setups. Some of them were relatively cheap and some were very expensive. And I'm convinced that if you really want to unlock your DAC's full potential, you will benefit from a high-end USB cable. For my personal taste, the Curious Evolved USB cable offers the best price-performance ratio. Not only does it perform magnificent between an Orrender N20 and a Solution 760, it also takes the sound quality of the more moderately priced RME to a whole new level. That is why for me, the Curious Evolved USB cable is an indispensable link in the setup. The Sennheiser HD660S is the latest evolution in a highly successful line of headphone designs that began in 1997 with the legendary HD600. The open-back HD660S retails for just under $500 and was designed for demanding music listening, both at home as well as in professional music studios. Besides revised optics, the HD660S have newly designed matched 38mm drivers with a frequency response of 10 to 41,000 Hz and an impedance of 150 ohms. The headband is adjustable in length and generously padded with silicone coated foam. The exchangeable ear pads are covered with velour. On the head, the HD660S sits quite firmly. Nevertheless, they are still comfortable enough to wear during long listening sessions. These headphones easily reproduce the entire audible frequency range, from real deep bass to well above 20 kHz, and the open design of these headphones makes music sound very spacious. In combination with the crossfeed function of the RME, it's almost as if you are listening to speakers instead of headphones. The bass is deep, dry and controlled. However, as is to be expected with the open construction, it is not as powerful as many closed models. The mids are well defined, voices are easy to understand and instruments are clearly contoured and naturally reproduced. The highs are rich in transparency and I often discover details that I haven't heard before. What these headphones do not do is sugarcoating, and they will clearly reveal the difference between two separate recordings of the same album or any imperfections in a production. This combination of the RME 82 DAC FS, the Curious Evolved USB cable and the Sennheiser HD660S is by far the cleanest sounding, most detailed setup that I have ever had here on my desk. I have for example an excellent recording from Nena's mega hit Nornenonsi Luftballons, and during the first few phrases, the opening and closing of her mouth sounds so detailed that it's almost like she's kissing my ears. All three manufacturers have created a masterpiece with these products, and I believe after having experimented with several other setups, with this particular setup, I have found true synergy. And that's it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I truly hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a thumbs up and see you next time.